फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एसएम लेक्चर सीरीज। योर ओनली स्टॉप टू गेट ऑल द नॉलेज ऑफ फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस, कैडकैम, सीएई एंड मेनी अदर सब्जेक्ट्स। ऑल्सो योर वन स्टॉप डेस्टिनेशन टू लर्न सॉफ्टवेयर्स लाइक सॉलिड वर्क्स, मास्टर कैम, ऑटोडेस्क फ्यूजन 360 एंड मेनी मोर टू कम। प्लीज डू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू स्टे अपडेटेड विद द लेटेस्ट नॉलेज। थैंक यू। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फाइनाइट एलिमेंट एनालिसिस लेक्चर सीरीज। टुडे वी विल सी शेप फंक्शंस एंड इंटरपोलेशन फंक्शंस फॉर क्यूबिक बार एलिमेंट। ओके, एंड स्टार्टिंग विद द ग्लोबल कोऑर्डिनेट्स। ओके, सो स्टार्टिंग विद द ग्लोबल कोऑर्डिनेट्स फर्स्ट। सो हियर आई हैव ड्रॉन द क्यूबिक बार एलिमेंट। सो क्यूबिक बार एलिमेंट इज स्टिल ए वन डायमेंशनल एलिमेंट, बट इट विल हैव four nodes, okay, in this manner. So this is a global reference and the individual distances of each node from the global reference. So the variable, field variable or the coordinate variable is x, okay, in the horizontal direction. And in a similar way, okay, we are going to find the shape functions for each node by following the property of shape function. So we have generated these equations. So this is the value of x at node 1, value of x at node 2 which is x2, value of x at node 3 which is x3, and at node 4 is x4. So we bring everything on one side and generate these equations, and we say, okay, in a similar way the shape function is equal to shape factor multiplied by all these equations at individual node. And whenever we have to find the value of shape function at a particular node, okay, so that particular equation we omit. Okay, that particular equation we omit. So what happens is, at node 1, let's say, we know that n is equal to n1 is equal to 1 and value of x is x1. And what we do is, we delete x minus x1. So we are left with n1 is equal to shape factor multiplied by x minus x2, x minus x3, x minus x4. Now we use the end condition. So n1 value at node number 1 is 1, okay, in order to find the shape factor. So shape factor multiplied by, we know also at node number 1, x is equal to x1. So everywhere we will replace this x by x1. So x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3, and x1 minus x4. Okay, so my shape factor eventually becomes 1 upon x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3. And x1 minus x4, and that is the reason why when I put this shape factor back into this equation, okay, back into this equation here, I get the value of shape function at node number 1, which is x minus x2, x minus x3, x minus x4 divided by x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3, and x1 minus x4. So this is the shape function at node number 1, which is n1. Okay, on the similar lines we can find the shape functions on all the remaining nodes. Okay, if you remember, we had come up with this general formula, okay, n i over j. So j could be the remaining nodes and I could be the node under consideration, okay, in that element, which is given by n minus, not n, is basically x minus xj upon x of I minus xj. So this particular activity we will have to do for every j. Okay, if there are more than 1, 2, 3 j's present. So let's say for a linear bar element only one j will be present. Okay, but for quadratic bar and cubic bar there will be more than one value of j present. So we will have to keep on multiplying in the numerator as well as in the denominator. Okay, so keeping that in mind, if we directly find the value of, let's say, n2, where the j value is going to be 1, 3, 4, so this will be directly found out as x minus x1, x minus x3, x minus x4 divided by x2 minus x1, x2 minus x3, x2 minus x4. Okay, similarly we can find out for n3, where my j values will be 1, 2, 4. So I will write x minus x1 in the numerator multiplied by x minus x2 multiplied by x minus x4. In the denominator I will write x3 minus x1, x3 minus x2, x3 minus x4, and the final shape function, that is n4 at 1, 2, 3 will be given as x minus x1, x minus x2 multiplied by x minus x3 divided by x4 minus x1, x4 minus x2, x4 minus x3. So these are all the shape functions for the cubic bar element in the global coordinates. Okay, global coordinates. Next up, we will find the shape functions for cubic bar element in the local coordinate, and we know that in local coordinates the domain boundary is between 0 to L and the origin is on the left node of the element. So this is the origin, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is x equal to 0. Okay, now this division, okay, will be having same intervals in between them. So these nodes will be equidistant, okay, equidistant from each other. So this is going to be L by 3, this is going to be 2L by 3, and this is going to be L. So if I bring everything on one side, this will be still remaining the same, x equal to 0. This will become x minus L by 3 equal to 0. This will become x minus 2L by 3 equal to 0, and this will become x minus L. So these are the four equations at these four nodes that we get. And I know that shape function is equal to shape factor multiplied by all these equations. So x minus L by 3, then x minus 2L by 3, and x minus L. So now when we are at node 1, okay, I know that my shape function value is n1, which eventually is 1, and value of x at node number 1 is 0. So I will be deleting this, okay, I will be deleting x equal to 0 from the above equation, or for that matter I will be deleting x. Okay, so what I will have? I will have n1 is equal to shape factor multiplied by x minus l by 3, x minus 2l by 3 multiplied by x minus l. So now I know that if I use the limiting condition, so value of n1 at node number 1 is 1. So shape factor, and value of x at node number 1 is 0. 0 minus l by 3, 0 minus 2l by 3, 0 minus l. So what I will get? It is going to be 2l cube divided by 9. 2l cube divided by 9. So that turns out to be shape factor. So this minus multiplied by minus will be plus, multiplied by minus will be minus. So eventually this turns out to be minus 9 by 2l cube, and my shape function will be minus 9 by 2l cube multiplied by x minus l by 3, x minus 2l by 3, x minus l. Let me write this correctly. Yeah, so this is what the shape function at node number 1 in terms of the local coordinates for the cubic bar element. As you can see, the shape function is also of cubic nature because it has x cube term present in it, okay, which follows the behavior of the element. The same thing we can find out for the node 2. So let's say at node 2 I have n equal to n2 equal to 1, and at node 2 value of x is l by 3. So I will be deleting the second term, that is x minus l by 3. And rewriting the equation as n2 equal to shape factor multiplied by x multiplied by x minus 2l by 3 multiplied by x minus l. So I will use these limiting conditions. So n2 equal to 1, okay, is equal to shape factor multiplied by value of x at node number 2 is what? L by 3. It is l by 3. Here it is l by 3 minus 2l by 3, and here also it is l by 3 minus l. So if I do the subtraction, okay, I will find that eventually my shape factor turns out to be, okay, I have just have to do the subtraction. So l by 3 minus 2l by 3 is going to be minus l by 3. It is going to be minus l by 3. And l by 3 minus l is also going to be minus 2l by 3. Okay, minus 2l by 3. So minus l by 3 multiplied by minus 2l by 3 multiplied by l by 3. That will eventually be a positive number, and it is going to be, I guess it is going to be 2l cube divided by 27. So when I bring it onto the other side, okay, my shape factor becomes 27 by 2l cube, and eventually my shape function n2 becomes 27 by 2l cube multiplied by x multiplied by x minus 2l by 3 multiplied by x minus l. So this is what the value of shape function at node 2 for the cubic bar element. On the similar lines, at node 3 we know that n is equal to n3 is equal to 1, and value of x is what? 2l by 3. So we will be deleting the third term in order to find the shape factor. So that is x minus 2l by 3. I am going to rewrite the above equation in terms of l3 as shape factor multiplied by x minus l by 3 multiplied by x minus l multiplied by x minus l. So when we will use the limiting conditions, okay, n3 will be 1, x value is what? 2l by 3. So 2l by 3 multiplied by 2l by 3 minus l by 3. Here also 2l by 3 minus l. So now if I find the shape factor over here, okay, 2l by 3 minus l by 3 is l by 3. And 2l by 3 minus l is minus l by 3. Okay, is minus l by 3. So I will get a minus answer as for the shape factor, and it is going to be the opposite of that of the shape factor which we got for node 2. So it is going to be minus 27 by 2l cube, and that will give me my shape function at node 3 is minus 27 by 2l cube multiplied by x multiplied by x minus l by 3 multiplied by x minus l. So this is the shape function at node number 3. And similarly at, let's say, node 4, I have n4 equal to 1 and value of x is l. So we will be deleting the last term over here, which is x minus l, which is x minus l. And if I put the values into the equation, okay, I will get n4 is equal to shape factor multiplied by x minus 2l by 3. Sorry, first is the l by 3, then x minus 2l by 3. Okay, and if I use these limiting conditions, I will get the value of shape factor, which in turn comes out to be, so this is what l, and here it is l minus l by 3, here it is l minus 2l by 3. So now shape factor will be, okay, l minus l by 3 is 2l by 3, and l minus 2l by 3 is l by 3. Okay, so eventually when I multiply, okay, I will get this as 9 positive, okay, 9 by 2l cube as the value of shape factor, and my n4 eventually becomes 9 by 2l cube multiplied by x minus l by 3 multiplied by x minus 2l by 3. So that is the value of my this is the value of my n4. So I hope you have understood the procedure to find the shape functions for cubic bar element, okay, in terms of its local coordinates, okay, in terms of x and l. Okay, of course, in all the cases, okay, the interpolation functions remains the same, okay, be it global coordinate system, local coordinate system, or the next coordinate system which we are going to see, which is a natural coordinate system. So next up, we will see the natural coordinate system. Okay, so okay, natural coordinates. Now natural coordinate will have origin at the center of element, so somewhere here, not on any node. Not on any node, it will be right at the center, and the variable is zeta. So this is node number 1, 2, 3, 4, we know that the zeta will always vary between minus 1 and plus 1. Okay, so here the zeta value is equal to minus 1 by 3. Here zeta value is going to be plus 1 by 3. Okay, that is how the zeta will have its values, okay, on the in the scale of minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, having zeta origin at exactly center of the element. So equations would be of the order zeta plus 1 equal to 0, zeta plus 1 by 3 equal to 0, zeta minus 1 by 3 equal to 0, and zeta minus 1 equal to 0. So we now know that shape function is equal to shape factor multiplied by all these equations, zeta plus 1, zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1 by 3, and zeta minus 1. Now when we are at a typical node, okay, to find the shape function at that node, we will neglect the equation at that particular node. So at node 1, okay, we know that n equal to n1 equal to 1 and value of zeta is minus 1. So what we will do is we will delete zeta plus 1, okay, from this equation and rewrite the above equation in terms of n1 as shape factor multiplied by zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1. Okay, and we will put the limiting conditions. For n1 it is going to be 1, and shape factor multiplied by zeta value is now what? Minus 1 plus 1 by 3, minus 1 minus 1 by 3, minus 1 minus 1. Okay, so now when we find out the when we do the summation and multiply, okay, eventually you will find that the shape factor turns out to be, it's not that difficult, okay, minus 1 plus 1 by 3 is going to be what? Minus 2 by 3 multiplied by minus 4 by 3, okay, multiplied by minus 2. So minus 2 by 3 multiplied by minus 4 by 3, so that is 8, and multiplied by minus 2, so that is minus 16, okay, minus 16 by 9. So when I'll take it on this side, it is going to be minus of 9 by 16. So my n1 turns out to be minus of 9 by 16 multiplied by zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1. So this is the shape function at node number 1 for a for a cubic bar element in terms of natural coordinates. Now similarly at node 2, I know that n is equal to n2 is equal to 1, and value of zeta at node 2 is what? Minus 1 by 3. So now I will be deleting the second term, that is zeta plus 1 by 3. Okay, you need to always remember why we are deleting these terms, because if we don't delete, then this equation will not be giving us any values. This equation always will give us 0. So we'll put the values. N2 is equal to shape factor multiplied by, okay, we will not consider this equation anymore. So now I will have zeta plus 1, zeta minus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1, and I will use the limiting value. So N2 value is 1, shape factor multiplied by, what is the value of zeta at node number 2? It is minus 1 by 3 plus 1, minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3, and minus 1 by 3, minus 1. So eventually my shape factor will become, if you do this multiplication, okay, as you can see, minus 1 by 3 plus 1 is going to be what? 2 by 3. Okay, minus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 is minus 2 by 3. and minus 1 by 3 minus 1 is minus 4 by 3. So if you do the multiplication, it is going to be 16, okay, 16 by 27, okay, 16 by 27. So in the and that will be a positive value, okay, that will be a positive value. So as you can see over here, it is going to be shape factor as 27 by 16, okay, when I will bring it on the other side, and that will give me n2 as 27 by 16 multiplied by zeta plus 1, zeta minus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1. So this is the n2, okay, in terms of natural coordinates for cubic bar element. Similarly, we will do it for node 3. So we know that n is equal to n3 is equal to 1 and value of zeta is 1 by 3. So we are going to delete zeta minus 1 by 3 term, okay, and rewrite the equation in terms of n3 as n3 equal to shape factor multiplied by zeta plus 1, zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1. And when we will put the limiting conditions, n3 will be 1, shape factor multiplied by zeta at node number 3 is 1 by 3. So it is 1 by 3 plus 1, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3, and 1 by 3 minus 1. So this is going to be the opposite to that of what we got for node number 2. So it is going to give me shape factor as, okay, you will see that all the equations are almost same but with a opposite signs. So this value will be giving me minus 27 by 16, and that will eventually give me n3 as minus 27 by 16 multiplied by zeta plus 1, zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1. So that is the n3 for a cubic bar element in terms of its natural coordinates. And then at node 4, okay, I have n equal to n4 equal to 1 and value of zeta is 1. So what I will be deleting, I will be deleting the last term, that is zeta minus 1, and I will be rewriting the above equation in terms of n4 as n4 equal to shape factor multiplied by zeta plus 1, zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1 by 3, and I will put the limiting condition. So n4 equal to 1 is equal to shape factor multiplied by, now at node number 4 zeta value is 1, so 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 by 3, 1 minus 1 by 3. So now I will get shape factor as plus 9 by 16. Okay, it's not that difficult to find. So 2, then 4 by 3 multiplied by 1 minus, so that is 2 by 3. So 2 multiplied by 4 in the numerator is 8, 8 multiplied by 2 in the numerator is 16. So this will become 16 by 9. When I will take it on the opposite side, it will become 9 by 16 and it is going to be positive. So it is going to be the opposite to that of shape factor at node number 1. And eventually my n4 will be 9 by 16 multiplied by zeta plus 1, zeta plus 1 by 3, zeta minus 1 by 3. So this is the shape function at node number 4, okay, for cubic bar element in terms of natural coordinates. So I hope you have followed this, okay, shape function finding for cubic bar element in all the three coordinates. Okay, in all the three coordinates, okay, my interpolation function is always going to remain same. So let's say this is the interpolation function. So n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3 others in 4u4. This is going to be my interpolation function. And let us quickly draw the shape function distribution. So let's say this is my node number 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me just copy it multiple times. Arrange it. The distribution for all the four nodes. So now how the N1 is going to be distributed is, okay, N1 value is 1 at node number 1, and then it is distributed in this way. So this is the cubic curve. Okay, this is the N1 distribution. How the N2 will be distributed? N2 is 1 at node number 2, and that is how this is distributed. So this is the distribution for N2, which is also a cubic curve. Now N3 distribution is exactly mirror image of that of N2. So it is going to be having value 1 at node number 3. Exact mirror image of that of this N2, and this is my distribution N3, and N4 is again the mirror image of that of N1. So its value is 1 at node number 4, and this is the N4 distribution, which is also a cubic curve. And how the interpolation function is distributed? The interpolation function is distributed in this way. So let's say I have some values. Okay, I'm not saying these are the only values that you might be having. You can have any values, but remember that the curvature is going to be cubic. The curvature is going to be cubic in nature. So let me just draw curve, and then we will give some values. So this is a cubic curve. Okay, this is the interpolation function distribution, and all these values, vertical values, are my u2, u3, u4 and u1 respectively at node number 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. Okay, the shape function finding for cubic bar element using all the three coordinates, and then plotting the distributions of shape function over the element, and also the interpolation function over the element. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you like my video, okay, please hit the like button, and if you want to watch more such videos, please subscribe to my channel. And also don't forget to press the bell icon. Okay, thanks everyone. Keep watching.